Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video lesson, we will see why we need an array. So without any further delay, let's get started. Double click on Turbo CI icon on the desktop. To start Turbo CI ID, select new from the file menu to create new source file. Now we are going to find the gross salary of an employee using this program. So let's begin. Include stdio.h include codenew.h void main opening brace closing brace. For this program we need four variables: float bs basic salary, gs gross salary, da dearness allowance, and HRA house rent allowance. Okay, CLR share printf / n enter basic salary scanf %f, %bs. Considering HRA equal to 15% of basic salary and DA equal to 80% of basic salary. Okay, so HRA equal to BS into 15/100 and DA equal to BS into 80/100. Now calculating gross salary. So gross salary equal to basic salary plus DA plus HRA. Now printing the gross salary, printf / n gross salary equal to %f, gs bracket complete semicolon get ch. Save the program as, pressing up to gs1.c, compile it to make sure that there are no syntax error in the program, alt f9. Now run the program using control f9. So control f9, I am going to enter basic salary, say 15,000, and according to that salary we have gross salary displayed on the screen. Now I am going to modify the program to calculate the salary of two employees. So I need second pair of variables. So bs1, gs1, da1, hra1, bs2, GS2, DA2, HRA2. So first of all, modifying this program, BS1, HRA1, BS1, DA1, BS1, GS1, BS1, DA1, HRA1, and GSA1. Okay, the program is okay. Now I am going to copy this whole code here and changing variable BS1 to BS2, HRA1 to HRA2, BS2, DA2, BS2, Ta2 and HRA2GS2. Compiling the program, it's okay. So in this way we can calculate the gross salary of second employee. Let's run it by using control plus F9. 15,000 gross salary of first employee is displayed on the screen. Say 18,000 basic salary of second employee, and you can see the gross salary equal to 35100 is displayed on the screen. So in this way we can find the gross salary of two employees. Consider we have 500 employees in the company. For one employee we need four variables. So for 500 employees we need 500 into 4 number of variables, that is 2000 variables. Managing 2000 variables is not going to be an easy task, and we have to repeat this code 500 times for 500 employees. Definitely this is not a good programming practice. Instead of creating 2000 variables for 500 employees and manage them, we can create 4 subscripted variables to store the data of 500 or 5000 employees. This is the power of an array. So in the upcoming video lesson we are going to learn how we can calculate the net salary of employee using an array. So that's all for this video lesson. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to watch the upcoming interesting video lessons. If you have any queries regarding this video lesson, please let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.